Alhamdulillah wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Happiness can be very simple. It's not always an extreme fantasy to try to attain happiness in this life, and to have that light in your heart, and to have that fulfillment. But rather, that fulfillment comes with our obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, in the beautiful ayat in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَدْعُوا رَبُّكُمْ تَضُرُّعًا وَخُفْيَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayat, call upon your Lord with humility and fear. That if you have this fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love and humility for your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can achieve that happiness. You can find that pleasure that you're seeking. And it may seem, there's no doubt that it is a challenge. It may seem impossible to some of us. For some of us, we can't even fathom this. But rather, it's not. All throughout the Quran, Allah lets us know that the mu'mineen, those who have faith, they are the successful one. They are the muflihun. They're the ones who are successful. They're the ones who have achieved and attained. All of us want to achieve and attain. And that comes through loving our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Him, فَدْعُ رَبُّكُمْ, you know, call upon your Lord, ask your Lord, ask Allah for your success and your happiness. He'll give it to you, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. But make sure you're in obedience to Allah. Make sure you're following the Quran. Make sure you're following the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And make sure you're following the path of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, which is the path of the Salaf al-Sadi. Don't be afraid of that word, the Salaf. Don't be afraid of it, but rather embrace it. Know that the Salaf al-Saleh is the only way of success. Why? Because they are the ones who transferred this deen to us. Allah used the righteous predecessors to transfer this beautiful, blessed religion to us. So that way we can have the comfort in our hearts when we bow before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when we ask Him, and when He gives us those the things that we desire in this life. And I ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.